Cuba, it's me. Welcome to episode 206 of The Willu Show, which stands for Wrestling is Life. Life is Wrestling. Now today, I want to talk about training to be a wrestler. Now, obviously I went through my training, I spent about a good 4 years training. You can never have enough training. You can always do more training. I would love to do more training every day. You can always learn. But what about if you're thinking of becoming a wrestler and you haven't yet, or you're just waiting for certain circumstances, or you're waiting for enough money, or whatever the case may be? I will tell you this, no matter how prepared you think you are, you will not be prepared enough. You think, you know what? I've watched wrestling for years. I've watched a bunch of documentaries on wrestling. I've read a bunch of books on wrestling. I've listened to a bunch of shoot interviews on wrestling. I've watched Tough Enough, so I know how the training is. It does not matter. It's watching it and doing it is not the same thing. I know when I went to wrestling school, I got a rude awakening. I knew it was going to be tough. See, I had myself psyched up that no matter how tough it was going to be, I wasn't going to give up. I wasn't going to quit. I was just going to stick it through. But it's no fun at first. You don't do any wrestling. You think that, oh, you're going to go there on your first day, you're going to get to do a flip off the top rope. No, it's not like that. Like, when I first started, I don't even think I got in the ring the first 2 weeks, at least not the first week. We just did cardio, constant cardio. So we would like do running of the stairs and other running and squats and jumping jacks and push-ups and sit-ups. And then we would do rolls, roll after roll, back somersault, forward somersault, judo roll, all these kind of rolls. That's the only time I got in the ring. I spent the first week working on a lockup, just doing a lockup properly. Everyone thinks it's easy. Oh, sure, you can lock up with your friend, but can you do it properly? Can you show your facials and all this stuff? You have to be able to show the crowd what you're experiencing. A lockup can start off the match and be the difference between a good match and a bad match, just based how your lockup is and how you translate that to the fans. But I will say this. If you are determined to get into wrestling, props to you. Go for it. Follow your dream. But it's going to be a shock to the body, and you might not even get the bump right away. But when you do, like, I'm not saying go in your basement and bump yourself on the concrete floor or out in the grass. You don't want to get a head injury. There's really no way to practice the bumps before you go and start wrestling training. But there is a way to get yourself into incredible shape. No matter how good a shape you get in, it's still not going to be good enough. But if you just go in there one day and you're not in that great a shape, and you don't work out currently, and you don't do cardio, and you walk in, you're probably going to end up puking, passing out, or quitting. Like, so get yourself as prepared as you can. Start working out now. Start doing cardio. You know, you don't have to pay for a gym membership to work out. You can work out just fine, just in your house. You can get a treadmill. You can just go for running. Just do some push-ups, do some sit-ups, do some squats. Get ready for it. Get ready for, like, how are you going to do a 30-minute match if you can't do 30 minutes of cardio? So I would suggest, if you're going to be a wrestler, start training now. It's never too late. Plus, it'll feel good to get yourself in shape. It'll give you confidence and stuff. And then I think the most important thing about training is one or two times this happened to me. I was 18 years old. I thought I knew everything about wrestling. So sometimes when the trainers were trying to help me, I would not, I guess, argue with them. I guess you could put it that way. Argue with them, but, or like say, well, I thought it was done like this. It doesn't matter. Just shut up and listen. Do what you're told. They're trying to help you. Do you think your trainer wants you to not be trained good? That's their reputation on the line. If they don't train you properly and you go and wrestle and say you were trained by so-and-so and you're not doing things right, that's their ass on the line. So trust in what they're telling you. And there's a reason for it. even if it seems backwards, even if you've heard another way or you've been taught a different way, learn everybody's way. And then once you go and have 200 matches under your belt, then you can start to incorporate your own way. But don't have an ego, because you can't learn that way. People aren't going to want to try and help you if you're not accepting the help. And don't feel like you're being attacked or anything like that. I know for like the cameraman, whenever I try and correct him, he can't take criticism. So I have to say it a certain way to show like, hey, I'm just trying to help you with your math homework. I'm not saying you're bad because you're doing it wrong. I'm showing you how to do it right. And I'm the same way. I don't like being criticized. And even if people are not criticizing me, I don't like being helped if I didn't ask for help. But if you're going to go into the wrestling business, you're going to have to grow thick skin. Because if you're going to be a wrestler, you got to go in front of a crowd, a live crowd, that is different than any live crowd in the history of any entertainment or sports at all. They could say the worst horrible things to you and you still got to perform and go and roll with it. So if you can't take it from your trainers or your co-wrestling trainees, then you're not going to make it. You have to have thick skin. I learned that right away. People will rib you. People, all in good fun most of the time. You'll have everything. You'll be called every name in the book. You'll be treated like a jabroni. Just humble yourself. Let yourself go down. I don't care how successful you are in real life and how good of a job you have, how smart you are, how great a shape you are. If you're going to be in wrestling, put yourself at the bottom of the totem pole and be humble and always willing to learn and always willing to help out. It was a real shock to me. Like I said, I thought I was ready for it, and I did okay. I hung in there. My body, it was a lot to deal with. Especially if you have like a day job too, it's going to be a lot. And then plus the diet, you have to be very disciplined about the diet. But I want to know from some other people's points of view, like when you first started training, was it different than what you expected? Did you start having more respect for the wrestling industry than you did before you started training? Like all these kind of things, was it a shock to your body? I'm sure what the answers are going to be for most people unless they weren't trained right. But as always, on the Willow Show, like or you get a leg drop, comment or you get a clothesline, subscribe or you get a suplex. Let's hear your stories of wrestling training. It seems like it is getting a little bit easier and easier as the generations go on, because they're actually accepting of people in the wrestling business. Back in the old days, they would do anything to not have you in the wrestling business. So at least that has changed, but I would love to hear some other people's testimonials. This has been episode 206 of The Willow Show. I'm your host, Elian Habanero. I love wrestling. Cuba!